Hi Sagittarius, welcome back to my channel. This is going to be for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and North Node. Let's do a love reading for you guys, Sag. Please remember to take what resonates and leave what does not fit for your situation. And also remember to flip and switch the roles. Could be talking about your person, okay? So let's see, I hope you guys are doing well. Spirit guides, angels for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and North Node. In regards to their love life, what is going on for Sagittarius? In regards to their love life, please. What is going on for Sag? Five cards. Oh, shit. Okay. What's that for? Yeah. Okay. One more, please. All right. Bottom of the deck, we have friends. You have a great friendship that could grow into more if you work on it. Okay. So we have pleasure. You will have a good time together, but it may not last for a long time. Oh, okay. Then we have trust. It came out in reverse. So, I don't know. You had a sexual connection with someone, or you have a sexual connection with someone, but you don't really trust this person. It says, have faith that the right person is being brought to you at the perfect time. Then we have karmic ties. You were together in a past life and you are resolving unfinished business. So somebody here could be dealing with the karmic, and it probably was just based on sex here. You don't trust this person anyway, is what I'm hearing. But there's a relationship here that you do have a friend that could grow into something more. Okay, then we have healing. This relationship is about healing emotional wounds from your past. That's that karmic relationship. Then we have divine timing. Be patient for your lasting love that is being created for you in the higher realms. Okay, interesting start. So let's see. For Sagittarius, Spirit, what is going on for Sagittarius in love? What is going on for Sagittarius in love, Spirit guides, angels? Please, for Sagittarius. What is going on for Sagittarius in love? Messages for Sag. Okay, Wheel of Fortune at the bottom. What else? What's going on for Sagittarius in love? All right, bottom of the deck, Two of Wands. Ace of Swords, Ace of Cups, Ten of Cups in reverse, Four of Cups, and the Five of Cups. Yeah, so there is a connection here that you could have had with the karmic. You could have had kids with this karmic or something like that. You know, there's new love coming in. Just basically, you're tired of dealing with this family situation. You're very discontent with your life right now. Very discontent, could be possibly in a connection with this family connection, or with the mother of your kids or father of your kids. Somebody here regrets something. Somebody here, I feel like, has left a connection and wants to bring this new love offer to you and bring you some type of truth and clarity, because they're very discontent. They're very unhappy. They can't even accept other offers because they're focused on you. I feel like this was a missed opportunity with you and this person, because they had a family situation going on that they possibly didn't really tell you about. Okay, but now somebody's seeing the truth of a situation. They're seeing the truth. Somebody here is just stuck on their past. The Four of Cups, Five of Cups, it's like they're staring at these three cups here. So this definitely could have been a third party situation. There could be family and friends involved in this. Got three here, three here. You could be seeing three, three. Okay, but yeah, it's like somebody is just focused on the past. I feel like you are part of this person's past. Okay, because I feel like this connection here could have been very sexual, but it ended very quick. Okay, because somebody here could have been like friends with benefits, is what I'm hearing. And this shit, you know, it turned into more. Possibly somebody's feelings grew for someone else. And it ended really quick due to them not telling you about a family situation they had on the side or something like that. I'm picking up a whole lot of shit. So let's see. Why is the Ace of Swords here for Sagittarius? Why is this Ace of Swords here for Sag? Yeah, Four of Swords in reverse. We have the Chariot, kind of like came out sideways. So somebody is having a hard time sleeping. Because I feel like they're up thinking about how they're trying to devise a plan here. Somebody here needs to get some rest. Somebody's very burdened, very tired. Okay, not really thinking too straight here. But somebody's determined to do something, though. Yeah, somebody, it's like somebody's awakening to something, though. They possibly are very tired, but it's like they had an aha moment. The Four of Swords in reverse could mean that you are kind of recovering slowly. Okay, it can mean healing, but it's like you're having a mental breakdown, but it's like, aha, I found out the truth. I want to say something. I need to say something. You're coming out of isolation to move forward. It's like, okay, I'm not going to sit and sulk in this misery. I'm going to move on. I'm going to move forward. Okay, some of y'all could need to get some rest, though, but yeah, it's like, you know, you want to move forward from something, so you're determined to do so. You're ready to move forward. You're ready to move on from a situation. Yeah. Somebody here could need counseling or some type of help, but they're not doing it. But I just see this Four of Swords as you coming out of isolation, because with the pair with the Chariot, it's like you found your strength to get up and move on. You're determined to get out of a situation. You're determined to get out of your head and get moving. Take action on something. What is this Ace of Cups for Sagittarius? Oh, damn. Ten of Pentacles in reverse. The Devil with the Death card. Yeah. So whatever this is, somebody here. Okay, so y'all could be seeing 10-10. I'm getting too many messages at one time. Let me get myself together. So, there's a divorce here. There's a relationship. There's a long-term commitment that someone is in for a very long time that has been broken apart. There's a divorce. There is a possibly fights over money. Okay, somebody lost a lot of money. I feel like somebody was stuck in a connection that was very toxic. Something about someone's finances too is heavy here. And you're going towards new love. Somebody could have tried to keep you trapped in some type of codependent relationship. There could be some like family members that depended on you to take care of them. Or there could be like some family members that are very toxic, okay, in a way. But somebody here got a big loss of material wealth. You know, it could be you, could be your person. But somebody here lost a lot of money dealing with whoever they were dealing with, this karmic. Something was very, very, very bad with this connection here. But it's coming to an end. This here is transforming. Somebody here is going through a transformation process. Okay. There could have been some disputes about money. Somebody here could have... It's like I'm getting a message like somebody killed somebody for... Somebody could have had something to do with somebody's death because of some money. I'm getting... There was some type of will that somebody left for someone else and they never received it or something like that. And somebody here had an involvement with this here. I'm getting a lot... It's like a whole collapse of an empire here. It was built off of like a faulty foundation, though. What is this Devil card for Sagittarius? Could be dealing with a Capricorn or a Scorpio, Cancer. What is this Devil card for Sag? Yeah, Page of Pentacles. Okay, so the Page of Pentacles in reverse can mean a lot of things. Somebody here could have been doing black magic. Somebody here could have been abusing their psychic abilities. But this was about money. Somebody had some type of... Somebody here could have even trapped someone with a child just for financial purposes only. Somebody here is a cheater. They're very disloyal. They're very dishonest. They're not stable at all. But the Page of Pentacles in reverse could mean black magic. Or dark magic. Or some type of magic for like finances or something. Yeah, in reverse it's not good. Somebody could have became obsessed with, I don't know. Somebody could be trying to do this shit right now since it's popping up in your reading. But yeah, it's like bad news in some type of financial matters or something like that. Somebody likes to cause instability in someone else's life. Whoever this karmic is just, I don't know, this is this unresolved karmic tie that you have with someone. But it's coming to an end with this death card. What is this death card about for Sag? Yeah, the Six of Wands. And then you can go on about your business. But this, yeah, whatever this is going to help you reach victory and success. Okay, whatever this transformation process is that you're going through, you're being blessed with new love here. But it's like somebody faked their love for you just for this, whatever this is. This money. I'm getting a whole bunch of stories here. It could mean a lot of things. But yeah, somebody tried to trap someone in a very unhealthy, unstable marriage. Somebody could be very unhealthy and unstable as well. But somebody has some toxic addictions here. For someone, if they were doing spell work, this shit is backfiring. If they were doing death spells, it's backfiring. Yeah, I don't know. Somebody here, it's like somebody didn't take an opportunity on something new. And they went on and did something with someone and got into a bad business deal, a bad marriage or something. They did something stupid. But it could have been due to like somebody doing magic or something to keep someone trapped or stuck. So somebody's ready to come out of isolation though, because they are done healing or they're just tired of being stuck. They figured out what the truth is and it's time to move forward. But this transformation is helping you heal here, Sag. I feel like you are going to get a victory in a situation. I don't know, for some of you, whoever did this magic or whoever did something in regards to your finances, they're going through hell right now, literally. They could definitely be on some type of deathbed because of the shit that they've done over material matters or material gain. Yeah, something here is backfiring. Really horrible. And you're riding off into the sunset. And that's fucked up, but I mean, hey, I don't know. You know. Somebody's very immature, lazy, selfish. They just want somebody to keep taking care of them. I keep picking that up. What is this Ten of Cups in reverse for Sag? Yeah, Page of Cups and the Eight of Pentacles. Six of Cups at the bottom. So, yeah, I feel like you're thinking about someone from your past. Somebody that you do share past lives with. Somebody that you have fond memories with the Six of Cups upright. I feel like now that you see the truth about this situation, you're letting go of this unstable family dynamic. You're just working on your money. Or this could be somebody here wanting to work on a connection with you, with the Eight of Pentacles. This person is working on their finances. I mean, they're really obsessing about getting their shit together so they can come towards you with an apology of some sort. I feel like this person that you're connecting to, they smell really good. Okay, they dress really nice. They could really be into fashion. But yeah, somebody wants to apologize to you or let you know how they feel on very much of an emotional level. Okay. What is this Page of Cups about? So there's a message coming in, Sag. What is this Page of Cups about? For Sagittarius. Ten of Wands. Okay, so I don't know. This message, you might not like it. It's just going to cause you a burden. Because this could possibly be the person that you broke up with. And, you know, you're just focused on money right now. You're focused on your career. You're really obsessed. I can't talk. Obsessed with trying to get your work life together. Your finances back in order after losing whatever this is that you have lost. And I feel like this person is trying to come in towards you with an immature apology. Telling you, oh, baby, I'm sorry. I want to work this out. After y'all already broke up, and you're just burdened. You're burdened by whoever this is. They're nothing but a bunch of responsibility and a burden. Yeah, the Five of Swords here. Yeah, this person plays a lot of mind games. And you just don't have time. You're trying to heal. You're trying to work on yourself. You're very focused on something else. You're very dedicated. Yeah, what is this Eight of Pentacles for Sag? Five of Wands. Yeah, you're just trying to work, and you're surrounded by people that like to fight, argue. Okay, there could be some competition here. All right, but this person just I don't know, they're causing you a lot of burdens and you're just over it. You're focused on something else, and while these people are over here fighting, this could be like something involving your job. Maybe you have drama and competition at your job. Or this person could be coming up to your job causing conflict and drama or something. But I just feel like you're just trying to focus, and you have this around you and getting on your nerves. There's a lot of conflict going on. Yeah. So let's see. Why is this? You could be ignoring this offer. This is why they're fighting with you, because you don't want to talk to them. You're moving on. Yeah, you're going towards your Empress with the Eight of Wands, this is good communication, positive communication, things moving forward in a positive manner, fast communication, fast travel, right? So you don't want to be bothered with that, whatever it is. What is this Four Cups for Sag? Yeah, you're working on your independence, Sagittarius. Yeah, Two of Cups in reverse. You broke up. You're ignoring an offer that once was something and it's not. You broke up with this person and you're single, you're independent, you're working on your money. Literally, the Nine of Pentacles and the Two of Cups in reverse means you're single as a Pringle. You don't want to be with this person. It's disharmony here with you and this person. You don't like them and you're setting boundaries. Yeah, you're setting boundaries. Then we have the Lovers and the Emperor. So yeah, you're just working on your finances, just period. You see that you're happy with someone else. Okay, I don't know why I said that, but that's true. So you're happy with someone else. You don't want to be with this person, and you're happy you're single. You just want to work on your money, and I feel like it's building. I feel like you could also be focused on this Nine of Pentacles person, someone that you actually do want to be with. What is this Nine of Pentacles for Sag? What is this Nine of Pentacles for Sagittarius? Yeah, Page of Swords, King of Queen of Wands. You got your eyes on this sexy ass person, or they have their eyes on you. My son is so nasty. I hope y'all didn't hear that burp. But yeah, so you're single and you're focused on something here, which is this person. You're watching the hell out of whoever this is, or they're watching you. This is you, Sag, the Queen of Wands. You're very sexy. You're very passionate. You're a go-getter. You're very abundant, and this person is watching you. They have their eyes on you. So they're single. I mean, if they were in a relationship before with the Karmic, they're out of it and they don't want to be bothered with it. I feel like somebody here is trying to get on your level now, because I feel like at first they weren't, because they were dealing with this Karmic energy, especially if they were doing magic. Somebody here was doing magic on someone. They got stuck here dealing with this Karmic and they found out the Seven of Swords. Somebody lied, cheated, or did something. This person was doing something with this person's money, with your person's money or something like that. But yeah, you find somebody to be very sexually attractive, very beautiful, and you want to bring them some type of truth. So there is a message coming in with this Page of Swords. Okay, somebody wants to bring you some type of truth and clarity about a situation. What is this Five of Cups for Sag? Nine of Pentacles. Knight of Pentacles in reverse, Seven of Swords, and the Page of Wands in reverse. Yeah. So, whoever this is in this energy, they regret. I feel like it's this Karmic energy, this energy right here, because somebody is getting off of their ass and doing something about what they need to do about their life. I feel like this is your person. I feel like whoever this Karmic energy is, so I'm picking up like third party for some of you, this actually could be your actual person that is in this negative energy. Okay, just take it how it resonates. Take the story, flip it, switch it, how it needs to be flipped. But somebody here is definitely very, very much immature. With the Page of Wands in reverse, they're a thief, they're a liar. Somebody here is really regretting what they've done. And I feel like it's this Karmic energy. Also, your person too, this is them sitting in regret. They know that they lied, they cheated, they did whatever. They conned you and they just play games. And so they're just sitting here sad. They're very sad that they lied to you about whatever this is. Because this person definitely lied. Your person lied to you too, as well as them being lied to by the Karmic. You know what I'm saying? Somebody is very, somebody's having a tantrum. Whoever this person is, somebody, the Page of Wands in reverse is like throwing tantrums. This person is very hot-tempered. They could be very closed-minded. Yeah, somebody's just feeling in lack. Okay. Somebody's lacking confidence here. There could be some bad news coming in about a job, or somebody's just getting karma. This person here that's in this Five of Cups energy is getting karma. Yeah, they're confused now, because they're getting somebody here is getting justice. They're moving forward. Could be a Libra that's now confused, that's now stuck in their head because of the shit that they caused. So yeah, somebody's very unreliable. You can't depend on them for shit. They're very unstable, this person. I do feel like a mental issue with someone. Not even trying to be funny. Yeah. Somebody's just not okay. Somebody could have lost a job. But something is not moving forward for someone at all, while you're over here getting new love and whatever else you're getting. So yeah, okay, I mean, it is what it is. I'm feeling like it's that person that did magic here. Whoever did magic in this situation is getting bad karma. This shit is backfiring. And I mean, as it should, because you shouldn't be doing stuff like that to people. Somebody here is just miserable. Somebody is just miserable. What do we have for Sagittarius spirit? Please give me some more messages for Sagittarius. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, North Node. For Sagittarius, messages for Sag. Yeah, what else for Sag? Bottom of the deck, we have falling in love again is scary. Yeah, so this person left a commitment and now they're scared to love you the right way. It says, I lack self-love, that's why I keep hurting you. Yeah, I hold on to you because you're my blessing. Coming back for you, it's real. This person is coming back. Okay, I feel like it's karmic energy and your actual person is. Are you hiding something from me? Are you hiding something from me is the real question. Then it says lacking faith. Okay, it says mutual energy. So both of you guys could be losing faith in this situation because you just don't know what's happening. X keeps coming in between us. Yeah, that's that karmic. That's who that is. My friend's gonna judge me. I feel like I've lost you forever. Hold my spot. Just looking for a good time. Yeah, this person, I feel like they came towards you with that energy and now they're getting their karma by dealing with this karmic. Yeah, this is their karma for treating you that way. Looking for a good time, blase blah. And now they're getting karma by involving themselves with this nasty ass karmic. Then it says keeping tabs on you. Are you looking for my replacement? For some of y'all, you are. You're moving on. Then it says, I know it's hard to trust me. We both know this is wrong. Up all night thinking about you. I miss holding you. Threatened by your hustle. Yeah, I'm not looking for your replacement. So they're wondering if you're looking for their replacement and they're not looking for anyone at all. That's why they're keeping tabs on you, because they want to know if you're dealing with someone new. I made you feel worthless, but truth is you were too good for me. Yeah, this person, the whole time they were intimidated by you. You had more than this person when y'all got together and you didn't even care about that. You accepted them for who they are, but they got intimidated and ran off with someone that was just as insecure as they were. Yeah. Then it says STD, burning, itching, leaking. Okay, this karmic, I don't know, it could be this karmic energy. Ew. And then it says, I know I'm still your best. So, I don't know, Sag. Somebody here is ew, okay. Could be this karmic with this STD, I don't know. If they gave it to your person or not, hope not. Okay, I'm not gonna stay on that for too long. So let's see what else. What else for Sag? Sagittarius spirit. What else do we have for Sagittarius? Okay, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, North Node in regards to this connection. Yeah, some of you guys are really getting new love. Once you find out this truth, and it might not set too well with you, you could be moving on. Bottom of the deck, we have awakened fears. Your worst fears are being awakened, such as rejection, abandonment, loss, or commitment issues, and bringing out all the skeletons hiding in your closet. We have divine mission. Your union will impact the world in some large scale that will help heal many on this planet through some sort of spiritual service. Incompatibilities. If you're looking for a long-term relationship, finding someone you're compatible with is key to avoid a very challenging connection. Safe space. Your twin will feel safer being friends first before getting intimate. Learn to enjoy the present moment and discover your playful side. Yeah, they want to take things slow because they just got out of this with this person. Okay. So for some of you, this is your twin. For some of you, it's not. Just take the message how it resonates. Okay. Then we have fifth dimension. The divine masculine energy is responding to the divine feminine energy and carrying out intuitive messages. Soul level connection. Yeah. running and chasing. You and your twin flame may switch back and forth between the two roles, often out of fear of experiencing true intimacy. Yeah, so I feel like you're the runner now, Sag. You're leaving this person because you're running away from them because you don't trust them anymore. Yeah, they completely ruined your trust with them. Just period. Then we have repetitive cycle. The predictable and repetitive cycle of an on and off relationship can be toxic and hurtful. So why put yourself through such an awful experience? Yeah. Separating from your soulmate can be painful, but let your pain be a catalyst for change. Go deep within yourself. Soul activation. You're awakening to your soul purpose and claiming your place in the world, feeling inspired to showcase your gifts and talents. Yeah, for a lot of you, this made you grow spiritually, okay? So you're activated. You're doing a lot of things now. Maybe for some of you, you're doing a lot of spiritual work because this twin flame connection helped you grow, okay? For some of you, this is your twin. Then we have karmic. Even though this is a karmic connection, it is meant to help you grow and heal so that you may find your true soulmate or twin flame. Yeah. For a lot of you, this you're in a karmic connection with this Sagittarius, or the Sagittarius is your karmic, or whatever. Switch it, flip it. Y'all know what I'm saying. And then we have twin flames. Yeah. So you found your twin. You found your twin already. You were just dealing with the karmic, or somebody didn't tell you that they were dealing with the karmic. And now for them not telling you and treating you like you're a throwaway or like you're just a friends with benefits, they're dealing with whatever this is because they kept running away from the true love that y'all have. Because you and this person do have a bond, but they kept running away. So now they're dealing with it. They needed to awaken, especially if this person was doing magic. So let's see. It says, you have met your twin flame, and even though it will be challenging, it can create a profound and life-altering sense of wholeness. Yeah. Then we have attachment. Get to know your attachment pattern so you can be more conscious in your romantic relationships and stop self-sabotaging. Yeah. Perfectly imperfect. The love you have for them allow you to accept their flaws and accept them for exactly as they are without trying to change them. And then we have intensity. The intensity of the connection is very strong, deep, and intense. And so overwhelming, you may run from it. Yeah, that's what it was. The runner-chaser dynamic. This is what this is. For a lot of you, it is your twin flame. Most definitely. So this was your reading, Sag. I hope it resonated. If it did, like, comment, subscribe, turn on your notification bell, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye, Sagittarius.